This channel intro you have just seen, many of you asked me how I made it. In this video, I'm going to reveal the secret. Hello everyone, it's such a Linux user helping you to install, configure and use Linux. Please subscribe to this channel and you will see at least one new Linux video every week. And in this video, I would like to share with you tools I used to make this channel introduction. I think Linux has very great programs to make good quality videos. But to make a really good introduction, having good tools is not enough. You need to have a good idea. Actually, the idea of having this channel art came from another Linux channel. It's Graham Linux channel. I really like his channel cover. I think it represents exactly what the channel is about. I wanted to have a similar channel art, but with a tux instead of a human being sitting at the table with a computer. Luckily, I have a sister who is a professional illustrator, and she helped me to create my channel art. Here's her Instagram page. If you're interested, check it out. And if you need to help with any illustration, feel free to contact her. So I did some search and I found this tux image, which is in public domain, so it's absolutely free to use. I downloaded it and sent it to her and explained her my idea. And she created this channel art for me. I have to admit she used Photoshop to do this. But believe me, if I had her skills, I would be able to make the same image in GIMP too. When I imported to GIMP, it was absolutely compatible. And as you can see here, for example, there are different layers with different objects, so you can make the same image if you have any artistic skills. For example, this is the tux image. You see it's a group of layers. So we can remove lamp, for example. You see this lamp here? We remove it, it disappears. Or we can remove the whole table. You click and you see the table disappears. So she created this channel art for me. And from now on, everything was done completely on Linux and everything was done by me. So I did the animation. I did a little more search and luckily the author of this image had another image, where the tux was from the site. And this was exactly what I needed, because I could use this tux to animate its movement from the site to the table. But before doing this, I needed to find a good music for that. If you have a YouTube channel, you probably know that you have an audio library there. If you go to your Creator Studio and this Create tab, you will find audio library. And there are plenty of musics here, which you can use absolutely free on your YouTube channel. So I searched for some bright music, which was very short, shorter than 30 seconds, and I found this cartoon Bang Haste track, which was perfect. So let me play it again for you. I think you recognize it. That was ideal, because when I uploaded it to Kdenlive, here's this track. When I play it, I could see that this jump peak was somewhere here. This was exactly what I needed, because I could make this point to be exactly when the tux is jumping into a chair. So I calculated how many frames I need to fill this movement, and it was 32 frames. So I knew that I need 32 images to animate this movement. So I came back to GIMP, I uploaded this tux from a site, here it is. I hided the main tux, so I hided this one. And I started to animate it. So how I did it? So first I placed it at the beginning of the frame, like this. Then I went to File, Export As, and I exported it. And I gave it name 0. Then I move it a little bit more. So when I do the movement, you can see that you can track it here by the pixels. So when I place it here, 200, so it was 100 before. Then I move it 200. I go to export. Export again, save it as number 1. Then I move it 100 pixels again. Export, export as, and export is number 2. And then I do all these movements until it reaches the table. From now on, I move it a little bit up. For every frame, I move it up, up, up. And then when I reach like 30 frames here, I replace it with another tux. So I put this one, make it of the same position, a little higher. And I hide this one. And I save it again, move a little bit more, save it again with another name, and the final one is on a chair, and I export it again with another name. So I got 32 frames like this. Additionally, I also wanted to be able to change my background easily, because I can have a different color for different videos. So what I did here, I separated the background, so then I hide it, my tags, and I export it as a background. So you can see this is the number one, so there is no tags here. Then I hide it and did all the animation without the background. I showed you this background because it was easier for you to see, but for example, if I hide it, so basically you just do the same. I move it, go to export, export as, and I export it as PNG, because PNG enables the transparency. So this is squares you see, they will be transparent. So I got 32 images. So here's 32 images, and as you can see, tags is moving on every of them. So if I open, you can see it's transparent and this tags is moving. So for every image, it moves a little bit. So if I play it very fast, you get the animation. So what I did next, I uploaded all these images to Kdenlive. And you have just seen this project. And every image is just one frame. For example, here you see it's 1, 2, 3, 4. So it moves like this. So I move it manually now, you see it jumps, and now it turns. And it jumps into the chair. So this is how I made it. So you can see how it plays if I play it in normal speed. So the last element was what to do after this bump sound, when the music starts to decrease. I didn't want it to be static, because it would be boring. So I wanted to add some movement. What I did next, I added some animation with the zoom tool. So if you go to position and zoom effect here, it's in crop and transform, position and zoom. You drag it and place it on your track. You can see here that I have some keyframes here. One is here, it's at the very beginning of this track. And another one is here, almost at the end. And if you look at the size, it's 110 here and 100% here. So I zoom by 10%. So if you look at this image now and I click on another frame, you see it moves forward a little bit. So there is some zoom effect here. So I added this zoom effect. And next when I play it, you see the image is moving forward. So it's not static and it's more entertaining, I believe. And this top layer is a transparent layer, and the background is another layer, so if I remove, you see there is no background. I can easily replace it with any other background. So I just need to go to GIMP, hide the tags, take a different color, let's say take white, create a duplicated layer, make it visible, and change its color. Then I just export it as, for example, if I write it white. Here's our new background, we can drag and drop it to Kdenlive. Then we drag it here. So we can remove this and remove this one. I place it here, drag it a little more. And here we have background image. My computer is not the most powerful, so that's why the speed of Kdenlive is not very good. But it's good enough to make a video. So the last step we need to do is just to export it. So you click here on render and you select where you want to render it. I use WebM format. This is a very good format. It has very high compression, but at the same time very good quality. It's the best to upload for the web. But if you want the best quality possible, you can use MP4. So I take it WebM and I save it as a test file. In more option, you can select the resolution you want to use. I use it 1080p here. And I prefer to have maximum quality here. And I render it. So the rendering was successful. Let's check it out. So here's our test file. And if you play it, as you can see, now it's on white background. As you have just seen, if you have a great idea, Linux has a good tools to implement it. Of course, it's not the best. And if you do video production professionally, you probably will benefit from using commercial software and other OSs. But if you're an average Linux user, as I am, you can use Linux and make really good content. Thank you for watching and don't forget to subscribe!